YouTube. Good morning on AOP YouTube. Not that it's really morning. It's about 2:30, I don't know, it's 3 o'clock. This is where the battle of Little Bighorn took place. Find some more history about it, because I don't know a lot. I don't know if it's a famous one with a little Custer's last stand. I don't know. I don't know if it was that one or what, I don't know. So we shall find out. There's a video what I can. In a bit.
Watch the Great Sioux Reservation in the South Cavalry, the Lakota Wars.
Little man, we are actually driving up is known as Last Stand Hill. If you look to your right, you'll see Indian Memorial. This was pointed in 2003, but not being finished till 2013 by Joseph Medicine Crow, our last known war Crow chief. He died in 2016 at the age of 106. This honors the five tribes that either scouted or fought in this battle, like the Crows, the Sioux, Arapahos, Arikaras, and the Cheyenne. If you look to your right, you will now see 7th Cavalry Memorial. This is actually a mass grave site holding up to 210 soldiers and 10 civilians. If you come up here later on and you look in that black gated area, there's one very particular marker with a black flag shield. That is where Custer had fallen and, of course, buried there. But later, his family actually removed his remains to be buried next to his wife, Libby, making Custer or Elizabeth. But if you look on both sides of the bus, you'll see Romans, you'll start seeing these white headstones. These are indicators to where these soldiers had fallen in this battle and were buried till actually they got moved back or moved to the mass grave at Last Stand Hill. Of course, 2 to 3 days later, after Terry and Gibbon come through to act as reinforcements, they thought they stumbled upon a mass buffalo slaughter, because when they looked in these hills, they just seen extremely large, bloated black things. So for those 2 to 3 days that they were sitting here, their bodies, and there was actually, that is, they were practically cooking. So, of course, we are driving by. In this wildfire, when they did the grid-like excavation, they found over 5,000 artifacts like glasses, wedding rings, belt buckles, stirrups, boots, and we're still finding a lot of stuff to this day. And of course, they found the remains of some of these soldiers and horses.
Oh,
And their commands was because Sitting Bull, he wanted people to go back and tell everyone else that they did not start this battle. It was not their fault. At this time, there'd be an officer by the name of Private Ryan. If you guys know the movie, he is not related to it. So, while he's in his rifle pit, he said, I looked to the left of me, a soldier was shot in the shoulder. I looked to the right of me, a soldier was shot in the head. So, he ducked down, sure enough, shot came up above his head. So, worry sets in for him as well. Because he, while he's watching what's going on down there, he has to figure out where the shots are coming from. While he's figuring that out, 16 other soldiers would die in the rifle pits. Finally, he looks around, he realizes, look in this general area, he sees a puff of smoke and dirt kick up. He found the sharpshooter. So he starts focusing his fire there now. He would exchange fire back and forth for over half an hour, as well as some other soldiers joining in. And of course, they will actually not go up there until 2 to 3 days later, until Terry and Gibbon arrive. Actually, this area is known as Reno's Retreat. That is where Reno and his men would guard up here in order to go into that area. They actually lost some more soldiers down there while riding up. They lost Dr. DeVolta. You can see their markers sometimes. So of course, when they go up into that area, they actually find no dead body. All they find is a stack of rocks, empty shell casings, and a as well as a trail of blood. Those stack of rocks are still there to this day, but it is overgrown. Sometimes you can see them, depending on. Oh yeah, apparently. Another story. This soldier said, I thought I shot this warrior off his horse. I looked behind me. There is no body. I can still feel the shots coming at me. So of course, these warriors were actually holding on to the necks of the horses and shooting from underneath. All the while, these horses are still running. So these soldiers, or these warriors, were pulling acrobatic shots. Crazy Horse's medicine was told no bullets or no white man's weapon can touch it. So, he proves this to be true. He tells his warriors are doubting him. So, he rides in front of all these soldiers, all the while over 60 soldiers are actually shooting at lame white men. And he is breaking up this group. None of those bullets touch him. He goes by once more, they still don't touch him. So, this encourages these warriors, that's where they'll take out Keel's company, and some of these soldiers are actually breaking off, trying to go support Custer at last at him. Like you seen earlier, there's groups of twos and threes of those markers. That is where they ran out of ammo. So, at that time, this is where the camp crier tells these warriors, stop shooting, here comes the suicide warriors. So, suicide warriors are a pack of young warriors varying from the ages of 14 to 17. They made a vow the night before, they're not going to see tomorrow. They're going to give up their lives in order to secure a victory and honor their families and their tribe. So of course they would get paraded into the visitor center area. They get off their horses, let them go, charge up last stand hill. And that Sioux warrior I mentioned earlier, Gall, he describes last stand hill and the battle there, as fast as a hungry man eating his dinner. So if you can imagine that, that was extremely fast. As well, this concludes my tour for today. Thank you for choosing the Saligat Tours. Gratuities are accepted and greatly appreciated. If you have questions, I'll be happy to answer those for you. Thank you.
Ew, YouTube. Can you guess where I am? Bit of a clue. Do, 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 do. Too much of a clue, you'll get that. Going close encounters of the third kind. Yeah. What a nice big TV. Kind of. I think I've seen that in a film somewhere. I can't remember what film it is.
Wonderland Caves, near Cavalry Regiment.
Good morning, YouTube. I'm at a place called Wonderland Cave. So, I'll just show you quick round. But just about to go below. A few bits and pieces kicking about. But yeah, it's like a guided walking tour thingy into a cave. Let's go and see. Not can see. I'll be the same. Thank God that means we've got to come back upstairs, haven't we?
Was the original way down, it's about 30 minutes to get it down to this point alone. Then you go down these stairs and the ritual tour is about 4 hours long on your hands and knees. But lucky for you guys, there's none of that today.
Not good. You're definitely not good if you're claustrophobic. That was the way in. Throat.
That's right there at our glowworm farm.
Really?
Yeah, have you ever seen glowworms before?
No.
Really?
No.
Why not?
I don't know.
Do you get in your back in
the school? What about you guys in the Canada play at the farm?
No, we just, I wanted to go to the cave.
Oh, listen to that.
Okay.
Yes, and touch itself.
Can I?
Yeah.
Alright. Oh, yeah, just
your shoes untied.
Huh?
Your shoes untied.
It is. You're right.
Yes, it is. You better tie it. You're gonna fall. You don't wanna fall. It'll hurt.
I know it will. It's got crooks. Don't have shoelaces.
Yeah, they do. Look. I'm serious. Look. Very tired.
Oh, in the winter, it'd be pretty cool down here.
It's still 47.
Oh, it's always the same?
It stays the same?
Yup. It's negative 20 degrees outside, it's still 47 here.
Huh?
Is anybody here scared backwards?
It is, isn't it?
Yup.
Yeah. I thought I had it. No.
Alright. Everyone else, what's the thing coming down from the ceiling?
Stalagmites.
Yeah, what's the thing coming up from the ground?
Stalactites.
You got it backwards.
I'm from Australia. Got ya. I'm not from England, but there you go. I'll put you off, Annie.
Yeah.
I did have him then, yeah.
You're 20 years ago is about 1 cubic inch.
That's pretty cool.
This can go back in there if you want.
Okay. Not a chance.
Oh. Try to quit. They just stopped and left everything here. That's why those two things are there, and those have not been touched since probably about
1945. Have a guess where I am. Yep, not much more. I'm a bit more of a wonder. It's all the avenue of flags. You wonder why. Maybe some flags. Now, apparently, to the other end of the valley, these dead crazy horse. I won't see him as well. Yeah. Not as small as I thought, but pretty cool though. Don't know names of them. Not one, maybe two. That's my phone off. I'm back to the bone. But yep, this is Mount Rushmore. Doing a bit of a touristy thing today. So YouTube, I am a crazy horse, this one now. It's still ongoing, as you can see, I'll turn you around. So you can just see his hand, but the you still see his foot. Probably get a better angle from around there. But he's on his horse, and I'll show you an artist's impression of all sculpture, how it's going to be like. Right, let's go and have a look in the museums. So that's what's going to be look like on the mountain. It's got a long time to do it. Very interesting. Fabulous bee work. Got to be done by a young. Oh look, a bee blanket. bit, but white leather, very hard to come by. You can see his face and his hand. It's taken a long, long time to carve. A lot of rock to move. Fascinating. In it. So this is what it's going to look at. And that. Got quite a bit to do. The equipment. So this is a piece of rock from the Crazy Horse Monument, which is over there. So this piece of rock will be going somewhere or other else that means important to the Native Indians somewhere. Yeah, in a bit. Catch you later. Bye, bye. See what adventures else we can find.